இதை பத்தி நம்ம பார்க்க போறோம். அதுக்கு அடுத்த போல செக்ஸ் லிங்க்டு இன்ஹெரிட்டன்ஸ், எக்ஸ் லிங்க்டு இன்ஹெரிட்டன்ஸ் அண்ட் ஒய் லிங்க்டு இன்ஹெரிட்டன்ஸ், இந்த தலைப்புகளை நம்ம ஒவ்வொன்றாக இன்றைய வகுப்புல பார்க்க போறோம்.
மேடி ஸ்டூடெண்ட், செக்ஸ் இஸ் லைக் எனி அதர் கேரக்டர், செக்ஸ் இஸ் ஏ கேரக்டர் விச் ஹஸ் டூ ஆல்டர்னேட்டிவ், மேல்னஸ் அண்ட் ஃபீமேல்னஸ். தி டெவலப்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் மேல் அண்ட் ஃபீமேல் ஃப்ரம் தி சைக்கோ இஸ் கால்ட் செக்ஸ் டிட்டர்மினேஷன். Do you know what is homomorphy? Having similar chromosomes. For example, in human beings, females are homomorphic, having two similar X chromosomes. And heteromorphic, in male, one X chromosome and one Y chromosome. These dissimilar X and Y chromosomes are called heteromorphic. Females are homogametic. That means they produce same type of gamete. Heterogametic, they produce two dissimilar gametes, X and Y sperm. Then what is Bar body? Bar body is nothing but inactivated X chromosomes, which is absent in male, which is present in female. Bar body is nothing but inactivated X chromosome, which is also called a sex chromatin. Learning objectives: to understand the mechanism of sex determination in human beings, insects and birds, and learns about sex linked X and Y inherited disease in human beings. Sex determination. Sex determination is the method by which the distinction between male and female is established in a species. So sex determination is a method. Okay. Then sex chromosomes. You know, we are all having two types of chromosomes. Autosomes are called body chromosomes. Allosomes are sex chromosomes. Autosomes controls the body character. Allosomes controls the sex character. Sex chromosomes determine the sex of the individual in dioecious or unisexual organism. The chromosomes other than the sex chromosomes of an individual are called autosomes. Sex chromosomes may be homomorphic, similar, dissimilar, heteromorphic. Individuals having homomorphic sex chromosomes produce only one type of gametes, homogametic. All gametes carrying the same chromosomes. Individuals having heteromorphic sex chromosomes produce two types of gametes, heteromorphic. Chromosomal basis of sex determination. There are two types. One is heterogametic male. In heterogametic male, the females are homogametic. Males are heterogametic. In this method of sex determination, the males are heterogametic, producing dissimilar gametes, while females are homogametic, producing similar gametes. It is of two kinds. Heterogametic, there are two types. One is XXXO, another one is XXXY. Now see, first you will see XXXO type. The females are homogametic, XX, with the two X chromosomes. while the males are heterogametic, XO with only one X chromosome. This method of sex determination is seen in bugs, some insects such as cockroaches and grasshopper. The presence of unpaired X chromosome determines the male sex. The male with unpaired X chromosomes produce two types of sperm, one with X chromosome, the other sperm without X chromosome that contains only autosomes. The sex of the offspring depends upon the sperm that fertilizes the egg. The next one is XXXY type or Liguellus type. The females are homogametic with the XX chromosomes, while the males are heterogametic with XY, X and Y chromosomes. This method of sex determination is seen in human beings and in Drosophila. The homogametic female produce only one kind of egg. All egg carries X chromosome. While the heterogametic males produce two kinds of sperm. One sperm carries X chromosome, the other sperm will carry the Y chromosomes. Here, the sex of the embryo depends on the fertilizing sperm. An egg fertilized by X-bearing sperm produces a female. If the egg fertilized by Y-bearing sperm, male is produced. Here, XXXO type of sex determination. Here you can see the females are homogametic, the male is heterogametic. When the female produces only one type of egg, all the egg carries X chromosome, whereas the male produces two types of sperm, one with the X chromosome, other with without sex chromosome. When these sperm carrying X carrying sperm fertilize the egg, the individual will be female. When the sperm without sex chromosome fertilize the egg, the individual will be male. Right? So, then in case of XXXY type of sex determination, here the females are homogametic, males are heterogametic. The female produces only one type of egg, whereas the male produces two types of sperm. One sperm carrying X chromosome, other sperm will carry the Y chromosome. When even these sperm, X carrying sperm fertilize the egg, it develops into female. When Y carrying sperm fertilize the eggs, it develops into male. So here the sperm determines the type of the sex. Chromosomal basis of sex determination: heterogametic females. In this method of sex determination, the homogametic male possesses two Z chromosomes, as in certain insects and certain vertebrates, producing a single type of gametes, while female produces dissimilar gametes. So in this heterogametic, females are heterogametic, males are homogametic. So here we are using the letter instead of X, we are using Z, instead of Y, we are using W. There are two types of heterogametic female. One is ZZ type. In this type, the female possesses a single Z chromosomes in its body cells and it is heterogametic, right? Producing two kinds of eggs, some with the Z chromosome and some without Z chromosome. While the male possesses two Z chromosome and is homogametic, so they produce only one type of sperm. This method of sex determination is seen in certain moths, butterflies, and domestic chickens. The next one is ZW/ZZ type. In this method, the female has one Z and one W chromosomes, producing two types of X, some carrying the Z chromosome and some carrying the W chromosomes. The male sex has two Z chromosomes and is homogametic, produce only one type of sperm. This method of sex determination occurs in certain insects, gypsy moth, and in vertebrates such as fishes, reptiles, and birds. Heterogametic females, ZO/ZZ type of sex determination. Here you can see the females are heterogametic. They produce two types of egg, one carrying Z chromosome, other is carrying without sex chromosome. And male are homogametic, they produce only one type of sperm. Here, sex is determined by the female because they are heterogametic, right? So when these egg fertilize the sperm, the individual will be a male. When this egg fertilized by the sperm, the individual will be a female. Then ZW/ZZ type of sex determination. Here you can see the females are heterogametic, produce two types of egg, whereas the male are homogametic. So the sex is determined by the female. Sex determination in human beings. The genes determining the sex in human beings are located on two sex chromosomes called allosomes. You know very well, in human being there are 46, chromosome number is 46, out of the 46 chromosome in 23 pairs. First 22 pairs are autosomes, the 23rd pair is allosomes. The 23rd pair of human chromosome include 22 pairs of autosomes, 44 autosomes, and one pair of sex chromosome X, XX or XY. Females are homogametic, producing only one type of gametes or egg, while the males are heterogametic, producing two types of sperms with the X and Y chromosomes. Here, male heterogametic produce two types of sperm, one with the X chromosome, other with the Y chromosome. Females are homogametic, produce only one type of egg, all they carry is X chromosome. So here the sex is determined by the sperm of the father. Then Y chromosomes. The current analysis of Y chromosome has revealed numerous genes and regions with potential genetic functions present at both ends of the Y chromosomes. Y chromosomes are pseudo-autosomal region parts that are similar with the regions of X chromosomes, right? Which synapse and recombine during meiosis. That constitute the remaining 95% of the remaining 95% of the Y chromosomes is referred to as non-combining regions of the Y chromosomes, NRY, non-combining region of the Y chromosomes. This NRY is divided equally into functional genes. One is euchromatic functional and non-functional genes heterochromatic, right? Male development. Within euchromatin region is a gene called a sex determining gene, SRY. In humans, the absence of Y chromosome inevitably leads to the female development, and this SRY gene is absent in X chromosomes. The gene product of SRY is the testis determining factor, TDF, present in the adult male testes. You know, Y chromosome is responsible for the development of male sex. Then another one is bar body or dosage compensation. In 1949, Barr observed a condensed body in the nerve cells of female cat, which was absent in male. This condensed body was called sex chromatin by them and was later referred to as Barr body. What is in mammals, the necessary dosage compensation is accomplished by the inactivation of one of the X chromosomes in female, so that the both the male and the female have only one functional X chromosome per cell. Here you have to understand, the male carries one X chromosome and one Y chromosome, female has two X chromosomes. But now the question arises, how it is balanced, right? How it is compensated. Here it is compensated, out of the two X chromosomes, one is inactivated. These inactivated X chromosomes are called a Barr body, which is also called a heterochromatin, which is seen in the inner surface of the nuclear membrane, right? Then this is very important. Mary Lyon suggested that Barr bodies are represented as inactivated X chromosomes. So what is Barr body? According to Mary Lyon, Barr body is nothing but inactivated X chromosomes, right? Which in female becomes tightly coiled into heterochromatin, a condensed and visible form of chromatin. That is called a Lyon's hypothesis. What is Lyon's hypothesis? States that regarding Barr body is nothing but inactivated X chromosome, first point. Second point, the number of Barr body is always one less than the number of expected X chromosomes. For example, and the XO female have no Barr body because here it is only one X chromosome, 1 minus 1, 0. Whereas the XXY male have one Barr body because how many X chromosomes? 2 X chromosomes, 2 minus 1, 1. So this is what we call this Lyon's hypothesis. 2 points you have to write. One is, according to Lyon, Barr body is an inactivated X chromosome. The second one is, the number of Barr body is always one less than the number of X chromosomes. Then next we come to that haplodiploid in honeybees. In this system, the sex of the offspring is determined by number of sets of chromosome it receives. The fertilized egg develops into female. The unfertilized egg develops into male. It means that the male have haploid, the male have haploid number of chromosomes and the female have double the number of chromosomes. The females are diploid. Hence the name haplodiploid for this system of sex determination. Here you can notice that the number of chromosomes, the diploid diploid chromosome number is 32, whereas the male is 16. This female undergo meiosis. As a result, they produce two types of meiosis. They produce two egg with of the number of chromosome, and one egg is fertilized by the sperm. As a result, it produces female. The other egg, without fertilization, by means of parthenogenesis, it develops into male. Then kin selection. Kin selection is a type of natural selection. It's an evolutionary strategy to facilitate sociality among the honeybees, in which only one diploid female becomes a queen and lays the eggs for the colony, whereas all other females which are diploid, having developed from fertilized eggs, helps to raise the queen's egg. They contribute to the queen's reproductive success and their own. This phenomena is called kin selection, which is a kind of natural selection. Next, we pass on to the next topic, sex-linked inheritance. My dear student, you know very well, we are having two types of chromosomes. One is the autosomes, another one is allosomes or sex chromosomes. Autosomes carries the genes for body character. Allosomes carries the genes for sex character. But there are some instances where the body character determining genes located in one of the sex chromosome, then it is called a sex-linked inheritance. Then the sex-linked genes, the genes that carrying that controls the body character located on sex chromosomes are called a sex-linked gene. And the character that is controlled by the sex-linked genes are called a sex-linked character. Best examples are then you know what is Hollandrich genes. Y-linked genes are called Hollandrich genes. Then inheritance of X-linked genes. X-linked genes, the best examples are color blindness, hemophilia, and Duchenne's muscular dystrophy. Then inheritance of Y-linked genes, the best example is hypertrichosis. Sex-linked inheritance. The genes present on the differential region of X or Y chromosomes are called sex-linked genes. The genes present in the differential region of X chromosomes are called X-linked genes. The X-linked genes have no corresponding allele in the Y chromosomes. The genes present in the differential region of Y chromosomes are called Y-linked genes or Hollandrich genes. The Y-linked genes have no corresponding allele in the X chromosomes. The Y-linked genes inherit along with the Y chromosomes and they phenotypically express only in male sex. The sex-linked inherited triad are more common in male than females because the males are hemizygous. It's a question becomes that the sex-linked inherited characters are more common in male than female. Mostly the sex-linked triads are recessive in nature. They follow crisscross inheritance. And the genes present in the sex-linked genes do not crossing over during meiosis. These are the characteristic features of sex-linked character. The question is, the sex-linked characters are more common in male than female. Why? Because males are hemizygous. Males are hemizygous. And therefore, express the trait when they inherit one mutant allele. And also, there is no corresponding allele in the Y chromosomes. There is no corresponding gene in the Y chromosomes. Then X-linked and Y-linked genes in the differential regions. Differential region means non-homologous region. Do not undergo pairing or crossing over during meiosis. The inheritance of X or Y-linked gene is called a sex-linked inheritance. Inheritance of X-linked genes. You know very well, sex-linked genes present on the differential region of X chromosomes are called X-linked genes, which has no corresponding allele in the Y-linked genes. One is red-green blindness or Daltonism. Daltonism is first Daltonic in the color blindness. Adhanal, red-green color blindness Daltonism அப்படினு சொல்றோம். அப்புறம் ஹீமோஃபிலியா அண்ட் டூச்சென்ஸ் மஸ்குலர் டிஸ்ட்ரோபி ஆர் எக்ஸாம்பிள்ஸ் ஆஃப் எக்ஸ்லிங்க்டு ஜீன். இது ஒரு கேள்வி கேட்கலாம், மென்ஷன் எனி எக்ஸ்லிங்க்டு கேரக்டர்ஸ் கேட்டால் ரெட் கிரீன் கலர் பிளைண்ட்னஸ், ஹீமோஃபிலியா, டூச்சென்ஸ் மஸ்குலர் டிஸ்ட்ரோபி சொல்லலாம். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் நம்ம ஹீமோஃபிலியாவை பற்றி பார்ப்போம். ஒய் ஹீமோஃபிலியா இஸ் கால்டு பிளீடர்ஸ் டிசீஸ்? இது ஒரு நல்ல கேள்வி. First, you know very well, hemophilia is caused by recessive X-linked gene. A person with a recessive gene for hemophilia lacks a normal clotting substance, thromboplastin, in blood. The females are the carrier of the disease and would transmit the disease to 50% of their sons. Hemophilia follows the characteristic crisscross pattern of inheritance. You know, my dear student, what is hemophilia? Hemophilia is also called a bleeder's disease. Why it is called bleeder disease? Usually, when a small wound is made, blood starts to ooze out. And the clotting reaction will take place within 2 to 5 minutes and the blood flow, the blood oozing will arrest. Whereas in the case of hemophilia, when a small cut is made, the blood will ooze out continuously and it takes 20 minutes to 24 hours to arrest the blood flow. In meantime, the blood will last and leads to death. That's why it is called a bleeder's disease. And it is also called royal disease because this character first appeared as a mutant character in Queen's Victoria. And from her, all their descendants got the disease. That's why it's more common among the royal families. It is also called a royal disease, characterized by delayed blood clotting. Color blindness. See, you know, color blindness was discovered by Wilson in the year 1911. What is color blindness? The person suffering from color blindness unable to distinguish red and green color. The red blindness are called protanopia, the green blindness are called deuteranopia. This is, you know, in case of human beings, the dominant X-linked gene is necessary for the formation of color sensitive cells, the cones. The recessive form of the gene is incapable of producing color sensitive cone cells. The homozygous recessive female and hemizygous recessive male are unable to distinguish red and green color. The inheritance of color blindness can be studied in the following two types of marriages. Marriage between colorblind man and a normal visioned woman. A marriage between a colorblind man and a normal visioned woman will produce a normal visioned male and female individuals in the F1 generation, but the females are carrier. The marriage between the F1 normal visioned carrier woman and a normal visioned male will produce one normal visioned female, one carrier female, one normal visioned male, and one colorblind male. This colorblind trait is inherited from the male parent to his grandson through carrier daughter, which is an example of crisscross inheritance or zigzag inheritance. The character is not directly transmitted from father to the son. Character transmitted from father to the grandson through the daughter. That means the character alternates of generation. That's why it's called a crisscross pattern of inheritance. Crisscross pattern of inheritance. See here, females are normal and male is colorblind. As a result, they produce gametes. In the first generation, males are normal, females also normal, but they are carrier. When this carrier female marries a normal person, right? They produce in the F2 generation one normal female and one normal male, one normal but carrier female and one colorblind male. That is three normal vision and one carrier colorblind. This is very important. Marriage between normal visioned man and a colorblind woman. In case of if a colorblind woman marries a normal visioned male, all F1 son will be colorblind. Because he receives one recessive gene for color blindness from the mother. So, since he is a male, single gene is mutant allele is enough to express the character. All F1 sons will be colorblind and daughters will be normal vision but carriers. So, what do you understand from that? Whether the father or mother, whether the father or mother is colorblind, the daughter in the F1 generation will always be carrier. When the marriage between F1 carrier female with a colorblind male will produce a normal visioned carrier daughter, colorblind daughter, normal visioned son, and a colorblind son. So here, the colorblind daughter and the son are equal, right? Colorblindness for daughter and sons are equal in the F2 generation. See here, female colorblind, normal male, whereas the F1 generation, the female is carrier, in F1 generation, male is colorblind. When this carrier female marries a normal, either carrier, the colorblind man, in the F2 generation, colorblind female and colorblind male are equal in number. Then inheritance of Y-linked genes. The genes in the non-homologous region of Y chromosomes are inherited directly from male to male, because the male only receives the Y chromosome from the father. In humans, the Y-linked or holandric genes are transmitted directly from father to son, because male inherited the Y chromosomes from the father, right? The female inherit only X chromosomes from the father and are not affected. The best example for Y-linked character is hypotrichosis. What is hypotrichosis? Excessive development of hairs on pinna of the ear. See, this is the hypertrichosis. Now we come to that self-evaluation part, sex determination and sex-linked inheritance. XO and type of sex determination and the XY type of sex determination are examples of, right, are examples of male heterogamity. ZW type of sex determination occurs in fishes, birds, reptiles, all of these. A marriage between colorblind man and a normal woman produce all carrier daughter and a normal son, option A. Heterogametic males are not in gypsy moth. The father of child is colorblind and mother is father of the child is colorblind and mother is carrier for colorblindness. The probability of child being colorblindness is 50%. What is lionization? You know very well, Mary Lyon, according to Mary Lyon, bar bodies are nothing but inactivated X chromosomes, and they occur as a heterochromatic and the inner surface of the nuclear membrane. And second one, the number of bar body is always one less than the expected number of X chromosome, and this is what we call it as lionization. Then what are holandric genes? Holandric genes are Y-linked genes are called holandric genes. It has no corresponding allele in the X chromosomes. And third one is it is inherited along with the Y chromosomes, so that they express the character only in male. Then define kin selection. We know very well kin selection is a kind of natural selection. It's an evolutionary strategy to facilitate the develop sociality among the bees colony, in which one of the female becomes a queen and lays the eggs for the colony, whereas all other females, even though they are all diploid and developed from fertilized egg, helps to raise the queen's egg and helps for the reproductive success of the queen and to their own also. And this phenomenon what we call as kin selection. Why do we call hemophilia as a bleeder's disease? You know very well hemophilia called a bleeder's disease because due to delayed blood clotting. A normal person, when a small wound is made, the blood stops within 2 to 5 minutes. The clotting reaction occurs within 2 to 5 minutes and arrests the blood flow. Whereas in the case of hemophilia, it takes 20 minutes to 24 hours to arrest the blood flow. In meantime, the whole blood volume will ooze out and it leads to the death. That's why it is called a bleeder's disease. How sex is determined in a human being? In case of human being, you know that XX, XY type, according to chromosomal theory, females are homogametic, produce only one type of egg, whereas the males are heterogametic, produce two types of sperm. One sperm carrying X chromosome, the other sperm carrying Y chromosomes. Here the sex is determined by the sperm which fertilizing the egg. When X carrying sperm fertilizes the egg, it develops into female. When Y carrying sperm fertilizes the egg, it develops into male. So this type of sex determination in male is called a Legeus type. Then explain inheritance of color blindness. You know very well, color blindness was reported by Wilson in the year 1911. Color blindness means the person suffering from color blindness are unable to distinguish red and green color, which is a recessive character. This color blindness is more common among the male than female because the male are hemicycles. Even a single mutant allele is enough to express the character. Whereas in case of female, homozygous recessive genes for color gene will produce the color blindness, which is very rare among the natural population. Homozygous recessiveness is very rare. It can be seen only the people who conducted these consanguineous marriages. Right? Consanguineous marriages, there you can see homozygous recessive. So it is more common in male than female. Next one is see here that the inheritance of color blindness can be studied with two marriages. When a marriage between a normal visioned man and marriage between normal visioned female and carrier the color blind man, all the in F1 generation, all the daughters and sons are normal, but the daughters are carrier. When these F1 carrier daughter marries a normal person in F2 generation, all the daughters are normal. Among the two sons, one is normal, one is color blindness. So what do you understand from here? The genes for the color blindness transferred from father to the grandson through the F1 carrier daughter. That's why it is called a crisscross inheritance. On the other hand, when a marriage between a colorblind mother and a normal visioned man in F1 generation, all the daughters are carrier but normal, but all the sons are colorblind, since he receives one recessive gene for colorblindness from the mother. When this carrier, colorblind, the carrier daughter marries a colorblind person, in the F2 generation, this colorblind female and colorblind male are equal.
இதுவரை நம்ம பார்த்த தலைப்புகள்ல செக்ஸ் டிட்டர்மினேஷன், ஹெட்ரோகேமெட்டிக் செக்ஸ் டிட்டர்மினேஷன், ஹோமோகேமெட்டிக் செக்ஸ் டிட்டர்மினேஷன் அண்ட் ஹாப்ளாய்டு டிப்ளாய்டு மெக்கானிசம் ஆஃப் செக்ஸ் டிட்டர்மினேஷன் இன் ஹனிபீஸ், செக்ஸ் டிட்டர்மினேஷன் இன் ஹியூமன் பீயிங்ஸ் மற்றும் செக்ஸ் லிங்க்டில் ஒய் லிங்க்டு இன்ஹெரிட்டன்ஸ், குறிப்பாக கலர் பிளைண்ட்னஸ், ஹீமோஃபிலியா அண்ட் ஒய் லிங்க்டு இன்ஹெரிட்டன்ஸ், ஹைப்பர்ட்ரைகோசிஸ், இந்த தலைப்புகளை நீங்கள் நன்றாக தயார் செய்யுங்க.